The startup and innovation community in St. Louis has diverse funding opportunities in the tech industry, and one specific sector, geospatial technology, is backed by regional efforts to supply their talent pipeline. The National Geospatial-Intelligence Agency is one of the region's largest employers, and with the construction of the nearly $2 billion NGA headquarters in North St. Louis, they are leading the headlines when it comes to geospatial news. But as the workforce report states, the broader regional geospatial industry supports 27,000 direct and indirect jobs at more than 350 companies and produces a $5 billion economic impact. And keep in mind, this impact is coming from an industry that barely existed 20 years ago. To better understand the geospatial industry and its potential for job growth in our region, I had a conversation with Andy Deering of GeoFutures Initiative. What is geospatial? It's very niche.
Tech
is huge.
Yes.
And this is a big, small part of what tech is.
It is. So geospatial, you hear things called geographic information systems or GIS. You'll hear all these terms used, and that's kind of the core science behind what we're doing. But the way it impacts you and me is when you go and you actually, you know, order some food on Uber Eats, or when you're ordering a vehicle on Uber, and you're able to interact with, what are drivers around you, or what are restaurants that are around you, knowing how to connect those pieces, knowing where you need to go, and all those things, they're all using geospatial information. Or you're going to a destination, how does it know how long it takes based on traffic and input? Well, we're all consumers of that data, but we're also producing that information to say, we slowed down at 6440 at the Science Center.
So like Waze.
Yes,
that's
exactly.
That's telling me that there's an accident up here and this is how long it'll be.
That's all geospatial technology and things that the underpinning of that. And so when we think about it, as you look at across industry, any industry sector, whether it be finance, whether it be agriculture, whether it be healthcare or others, they're all using location of information, whether it be location of people, location of things that are out there. And we can be a leader for that. There's nobody out there that's, you have Silicon Valley and it's all tech and there's lots of things that are going on, but you can get lost in the shuffle. For companies and organizations setting up and standing out here in St. Louis, we have the unique sets of skills. Mm-hmm. We've got all the other ingredients, whether it be venture capital, whether it be access to other industry types. Like, we're building, and that's what GeoFutures is, through Greater St. Louis Inc., is doing, is building that opportunity around that.
Give me a little bit more detail of the GeoFutures. What is that and what does that mean, and how does it relate to Greater St. Louis Inc.?
So GeoFutures was a roadmap that was developed to say, how do we become the global geospatial hub here in St. Louis, creating jobs, creating innovation, starting new businesses, and really standing out there and saying, hey, this is the next big thing for St. Louis for us to take advantage of.
Have I had my head in the sand? I don't recall hearing anything about geospatial until the whole talk about NGA and announcing that they're going to stay here and build in North St. Louis. Did I just miss that, or did that really sort of come to surface then?
No, you probably grew up, your neighbors might have been, geospatial professionals at NGA growing up, but they were kept very quiet. And granted, you'll hear a lot of news of them being the spy agency and those sorts of things. Again, they've been here in St. Louis since World War II. They made the aeronautical maps down at the Globe Building, which is kind of near the T-Rex facility downtown. And they've been quietly down by the river. They have a couple of installations that have been here, and they operate in the quiet. Now they've been very much more open about how to partner, and that's why you hear a lot more of it in the news, and you hear an update once a week.
Why now?
It's because of the location of their campus, and knowing that, we've been in, we're locating in a disinvested area, historically disinvested area, and the opportunity to actually do it the right way, working with the community, working with GeoFutures to help figure out how do we develop career pathways.
So where are we in the skills department in this region? Do we have the skills? Do we have the workforce? And if we do we have the jobs? Or if we don't, how do we get the jobs here without having the workforce? I guess what comes first? The workforce or the actual employment, the jobs, the companies?
So the interesting thing is, especially since the pandemic, the need for technical workforce has increased, and that is not slowing down by any means. So we have the demand. It's already there. We're not dissimilar than any other metro area that's out there on technical workforce. Where we are positioned is we have multiple partners. And so what we think about with the GeoFutures roadmap is it's a power strip. It's an outlet. It's got multiple outlets for people to plug into because of the demand and need. The geospatial industry was this, 10 years ago. It was this 5 years ago, and it's exponentially grown as far as the opportunities, job openings, career paths
because
that are here.
Because the technology has advanced so much.
Yes, and what we're doing here in St. Louis, where people can plug in and grow their business, mm-hmm. or they can plug in and support what NGA is doing, or what they're plugging in and supporting with non-traditional or non-national security.
So is there an effort to go into these schools, grab them where they are, starting at the youngest levels and educating them in that STEM area?
Yes, and there's quite a few. And NGA is the catalyst mm-hmm. behind this, but they're not the only partner, and they cannot be the only partner for us to be a hub around geospatial. They've done a great job of saying, we have a study, and they'll be very honest, versus our adversaries, the U.S. is falling woefully behind around STEM graduates. Mm-hmm. It's becoming a national security issue of saying, if we don't graduate enough STEM graduates out of any of our institutions, we are going to fall behind our adversaries, and they are going to be advanced against us. What they did here in St. Louis is they said, how do we start early? They have an initiative called K-16R, which is starting at kindergarten through, secondary education through, hey, wait, I might be in a different career field, but I want to get in this career field. How do I, through retirement, how do we upskill and reskill and grow the talent base using and setting that up for success here in St. Louis? And we have the right ingredients. So there are programs now that are set up with St. Louis Public Schools, with DESE, with others that have said, hey, we hear about this geospatial thing, but what are those training and skills that are needed from K through 4? What are they needed 5 through 8? And start working on what STEM skills or geography or other skills that are might needed to inspire youth to say, this is what a career looks like in 10 or 20 years in geospatial, and start getting them inspired earlier to where they see themselves either in this field or in some sort of science field beyond that.
Is this a four-year degree? Is this a certificate? What does this look like if someone wants to go in this field where if they think I have to be in school for 7 years to figure out all of this stuff, might look a little daunting, but is it, what do you need to get there?
All the above. And so the great thing about the pathways that are there to get a job in geospatial, you can have a high school certificate, Gateway Global, for example. They are the only high school accredited geospatial or GEOINT certificate that's out there. Only one in the nation.
So what happens when they graduate?
They can be partnered up directly with a company called Maxar, which you might have seen Maxar on the news when you're looking at satellite imagery of the Ukraine. That's coming from them.
Okay. So a high school graduate with that certificate can be partnered up with Maxar for employment and then continued training and education to expand their career?
Yes. We've got to scale that because there's over 1,000 open jobs in our geospatial industry today. Here in St. Louis that need to be filled.
And you're still trying to get more companies to come.
Absolutely, absolutely. This industry is moving so fast. If you look back 20 years ago, there were job descriptions called cartographers, people that made wonderful, pretty maps, right? Or intelligent maps. Now we can do that all on computers. Well, what are those skills that are needed today versus what were needed 20 years ago? And what are the skills that we need in 10 years, 15 years versus what we have today?
Right, so you're not even trying to get people involved in what's happening now. It's looking forward of where those,
Absolutely.
That career is going.
Yes.